So our first Wednesday in this great month, and the prophetic theme for this month is double grace in Christ secures my unlimited result. Double grace in Christ secures my unlimited result. And that is extracted from the book of John chapter 1 verse 16. And of his fullness have we all received from grace to grace. Of his fullness. You have all received from grace to grace. And on Wednesday, after Sunday, our teaching series is going to be the practice of the word guarantees total success. The practice of the word guarantees what? Total success, which is Joshua chapter 1 verse 8. God was instructing Joshua that this book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in it day and night. He said, then you observe to do all that is written in it. He said, then you will make your own way prosperous. He said, then you will have good success. So it is not by what God will do, it's about what we will do. Because God will never go back to factory again to start creating anything. In Genesis chapter 2, from verse 1, he said, then God rested from his work. And everything that God has created, he said, God planted, it is finished. Genesis chapter 2, verse 1 to 2. Amen. So the practice of God's word guarantees total success. So the more of God's word that we know, the more of success that what? That guarantees us. Amen. But today I'll be sharing with you on what I've titled, Understanding the Total Trust in the Word of God. Understanding the total trust in the word. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 to 6, please. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 to 6. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 to 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. He said, in all your way, acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. He will direct your steps. Everything falls on God's word this month. Without the word of God, there will never be a solution. The word of God carries solution. It carries peace. It carries everything that you can think about. So what you need is not what you need. It is the word that you need. Because God's word is creative. Somebody shout hallelujah. And you don't know the subtitle, which is what every most of you see on flyer, is trusting in the word of God. Psalm 125 verse 1. The day that trust in the word in the Lord are like Mount Zion that cannot be removed but abides forever. Amen. Amen. Therefore, Lord, we open this Wednesdays in an everyday meeting, including today, Thursday and Friday, into your hand. Let the hand of God be upon everybody. Let the strength come from heaven. Let this word find spirit fulfillment in our life. Let lives change. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
One thing I want you to know as we proceed on this subject is this. God is not your meat. The word of God supersedes everything that you can see. Second Corinthians chapter 4, verse 17, 18. He said, why looking at the things that are seen? Why not the things that are not seen? He said, the things that are seen are temporal. What you see is temporal. Look for Hebrews 11, from verse 1. We're going to read right now. Bible said Paul was writing to the people in Corinthians. He said, listen to this. What you see is temporal. So if you live your life based on what you see, you are a temporal person. You cannot last. He said, what you see is temporal, but what you don't see are eternal. Hebrews chapter 11, from verse 1. Let's go.
Now faith. Is the substance.
Now faith. Go ahead.
Is the substance of things hoped
of
for.
Things hoped for.
The evidence
of things
not seen.
Let's go, please.
For by it, the others obtained a good testimony.
For by faith they obtain what? Good testimony. So remove faith, no testimony. So testimony is a function of faith. For by it they obtain good testimony. Let that sink a little bit. For by faith they obtain what? Good testimony. For by faith they obtain good testimony. For by faith they obtain good testimony. For by faith. So, how did this go? Let's go.
By faith.
By faith.
We understand.
We understand.
That the word.
That the word.
Were framed.
We are framed.
By the word of God.
Okay, that is the secret. By the same faith that people obtain testimony, we understand that the word that we can see, we are framed by what? By the word that you cannot see. Everything that you can see in life is a function of the things that you cannot see with your eyes. Everything that you can see in life is a function of the thing that you cannot see, that you cannot see through your eyes. If you live your life based on what you can see, you have signed up for limited failure. You're living a life of champion, living a life of winner, living in the capacity where men cannot comprehend, where women cannot put side by side competition with, is the life of the word. He said, by faith we understand that the word that can be seen were made, were framed by the word of God. It was referring to what happened, the incident in Genesis chapter 1, verse 1 to 31, and John chapter 1, verse 1 to 5. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God's word carry power. God's word carry power. For your success to be guaranteed as a team for Wednesday, that means you have to be loaded with the word. Write it down. You cannot separate real success from the word of God. Because Bible said in John chapter 1 verse 3, it said through the word, everything was created. Success was a product of the word of God. So when you speak the word, success looks back. Because there is a connection within you. And if somebody shouts hallelujah. Jeremiah chapter 15. Jeremiah chapter 15 verse 16. Jeremiah chapter 15 verse 16. The TPT version says, your word will be found and I ate them. So if this word of God we are talking about is the secret to all things, he said, when you find that word, eat it. Your word will be found. So locating God's word is not cheap. It was found. Your word was found. The word was found. It was found. I want you to know this. Listen to this. Your next level is determined. Is directly functioning to your level of the word. How much of what the word that you know will determine how much of success that you enjoy. How much of the word that you can know will determine how much of the word that you can what? That you can enjoy. Life is a function of intention. Life is a function of intention. Your level of intentionality will determine of the life that you enjoy. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. He said, your word we have found, and I did eat them. So when they find the word, they don't put them aside. He said, I find your word, and what? I consumed it. So God's word must be consumed. God's word must be what? It must not be postponed. It must not become an interaction where people will dialogue about it. God's word must be consumed. Consume it all and eat it raw. You see, and your word became to me a joy. So what you do right by the word will give you joy. And the delight of my heart. For I am called by your name, O Lord God of hosts. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. And we all know this book of the Lord, Joshua 1, it shall not depart from you. Depart from my mouth, but thou shalt meditate in it day and night, but thou shalt we observe to do all that is written in it, then you will make your way prosperous, and then you will have good success. So good success is in the practice of the word of God. Good success is in the practice of the word of God. good success, no matter what is happening, locate what God says. Anytime you locate what God says, everything that is happening will come back and yield to you. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. In this introduction, I want you to know there are three things in the Word of God. The three virtues of the Word of God. Let me pray like that. The three virtues of the Word of God. Number one, the Word is creative. There is a creative virtue in the Word of God. No matter what is missing in your life, in your destiny, no matter the mistake that you have made, if you locate the Word, there are three types of Word, but that's not part of teaching today. There are what we call a sent Word, a right Word, and the Word in the season. God's Word is creative. I'm speaking to you tonight. If there's any part of you that the doctor has declared as no, is dead, as I speak to you right now, let the creative part of the Word of God enter into your body.
Amen.
Enter into your soul.
Amen.
Enter into your spirit.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus. John 1, 1 to 5. John 1, 1 to 5. In the beginning. In the beginning. There is Word. The Word was with God. And the Word was God. The same was in it with Him in the beginning. It's via the Word everything is created. And without the Word nothing is created. He said, in Him was life, and the life was light, and the light shined, darkness cannot comprehend it. Inside the Word of God is unstoppable force. God's Word cannot be stopped, not by day, not by night, not by anybody. When you locate God's Word, success is guaranteed for you. He said, in this Word of God, there is a creative forces on it. You know, that was why the centurion in Matthew chapter 8, verse 8, he said, Master, he said, speak the word only. I'm not worried that you come to my house. Speak the word, because the word can transfer or can travel faster than a jet. God's word can travel faster than a jet. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And, you know, Genesis chapter 1, verse 3, is that God said, let there be light. Until God used the word, light became not the same. Because of time, number two, what is in the word? The word of God carries surgical ability. The word of God is creative. The word of God is surgical. If there's any part in your body that you're having pain right now, I want you to please, wherever you are, be connected, remove your shoe and put it on this floor. And let the anointing upon this altar flow around your house in the mighty name of Jesus. As you put your foot on the floor, there will be a connection that whatsoever sickness that is ravaging other people's life, Lord, by the power of today, let such a sickness disappear in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So God was his creative. Number two, God was his surgical. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 9. God's word is surgical. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12. He said, for God's word is quick, powerful, sharper than every two-edged sword. You see that? He continued. He said, piercing even to the dividing asunder. God's word has the capacity to get to anywhere. God's word. Unstoppable. God's word. Undecodable. God's word. All things that you can imagine. That's the word of God that we are talking about. Number one, God's word is creative. Number two, God's word is surgical. It's surgical. But another version said, the word of God is living, active. That's Pastor Bashop. He said the word of God is active. It never goes on break. The word of God is active. Number two, the word of God is surgical. Number three, of course, the word of God is not just surgical. The word of God is not just creative. The word of God is medicinal. Proverbs chapter 4, verse 20. Proverbs chapter 4, verse 20. He said, my son, attend to my word. Incline thy ear unto my saying. He said, let them not depart from your eyes. Keep them in the midst of your heart. For they are life to those that find them and aid to your own soul. So wherever you are walking from, speak the word of God. Don't be afraid of the people. Speak, somebody say, I will speak the word of God. Speak the word. Speak the word. Speak the word. Speak the word. Speak it every time. What you say every time will one day be productive, unlimited, that's going to end you for the rest of your life. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I found a combo scripture long time ago when I was in Nigeria. Hebrews chapter 1 verse 5. I want to share it with you today. Pray for strength in us today. I want to show you this combo. When you receive the combo, you'll be surprised at what is the thing that will happen to you. Somebody shout hallelujah. Hebrews 1:5.
For to which of the angels did he ever say,
mm-hmm.
you are my son,
mm-hmm.
today I have begotten you, and again I will be to him a father, and he shall be to me a son.
Amen. Let's turn to Habakkuk chapter 1 verse 5. Habakkuk was, go ahead.
Look among the nations.
Look among the nation.
And watch.
And watch.
You're utterly astounded.
Yes.
I will work a work in your days.
I will do a miracle in your days.
Which you will not
be. Listen, maybe, you know, maybe because some of us are in Nigeria now. I'm not in Nigeria again. I don't understand. No. I was coming from Canaan that day when the Lord opened. No, Papa was preaching. That was when this scripture jumped out to me. And when I got home, I looked for 4-3 other scriptures that backs it up. Because out of what? 2-3 witnesses, shall the word of God be established. Somebody said hallelujah. He said, behold, read again. Behold the hidden.
Look among the nations.
Look at them.
And watch. Be utterly astounded.
Yes.
For I will work a work in your
days. For I will work a work. The word means that I'm going to give you a miracle. I'm going to place you in a place. He said, if they told you, you will not believe. God's word. God's word. God's word. God's word. Amen.
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 He said, the kind of how I'm going to decorate you, if somebody tells you this, you say no. So, what then happened? Why will God do such a work? That's the question that I was asking myself. And I was in the bus going back to home. Canada. I was, God, why would you do this when the world is full of cruelty? There is no peace. God said, Isaiah chapter 48, verse 11. Isaiah chapter 48, verse 11. He said, for my sake. He said, I'm not doing it for your sake. You know, we are talking about trusting in God. Until you locate the word of God and hold it firm to yourself, you are by yourself. Habakkuk 1:5, Isaiah chapter 48 verse 11, and Proverbs chapter 30 verse 5. That's where those scriptures are coming. Because if you don't wrestle with life, you can never get the best of life. Wrestle to move forward. Wrestle to make sure, you might be tired but show up. Isaiah 48 verse 11. He said, for thy sake, it is not for your sake. For my sake. For my sake. Isaiah 48 verse 11. Can somebody help us to read?
For my sake.
For my sake.
For my own sake.
For my own sake.
I will do it.
Oh my God, maybe you don't understand. You don't understand. God said, I don't want to decorate you for you. I want to decorate you for me. I don't want to pass you. I don't want to pass you from the exam that you don't do well for you. I'm doing it for me. Because God will not want the people to look at God and say, hey, shame. There will never be any shame in God. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He said, for myself, even for my own sake, I will do it. He said, for how many names shall be populated? Polluted. Mm-hmm. So that's the third scripture, right? Number one is what? Habakkuk 1:5. Number two is what?
Isaiah 48:11.
Isaiah 48:11. And number two is what?
Proverbs 30.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. One more scripture to back up. Back it up. Psalm 33 verse 4. Psalm 33 verse 4. He said, for the word of God. You know, I can still picture myself when I was asking God this question. When I go back to that age. Most of this scripture does not come on time, but it came. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So, Habakkuk 1:5, Isaiah chapter 48 verse 11, Proverbs chapter 30 verse 5, and what? Psalm 33 verse 4. Those words change me that, hey, what God wants to do is not for me, it's for his sake. You know, I called somebody today that I want to pay the person's school fees. And the person said, listen, you are not helping me. He said, you are not helping me, you are helping yourself. I said, okay, if that is the case, I don't want to help myself again. Let me keep my money. What people, most of the people don't know, when God is working in your life, just learn how to say, thank you, Lord. Don't ask him, why is this here? Why is not here? He does not need you. Amen.
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 So, what are the four combo scriptures? Number one, Habakkuk 1:5, Isaiah 48 verse 11, Proverbs 30 verse 5, and Psalm 34 verse 5. That leads us to what you know, that if we know in our knowing that God's word carry all these virtues that we have mentioned, then Matthew 24 verse 35 is the answer. He said, heaven and earth may pass away, but not God's word. God's word established, no matter how difficult it is, God will find a way around it. Because all things belong to God. All things. But the things that are revealed belong to us and our children. Deuteronomy 29, verse 29. He said, let's go back to that Matthew 24, verse 35. He said, heaven and earth may pass away. They will pass. Heaven and earth, they will pass. Heaven and earth, they will pass. But one thing that will not pass is what? It's God's word. So the absence of God's word brings unlimited trouble. For example, you know, why people are struggling because they don't locate God's word. Well, you can locate God's word in all situations, you'll be rest assured. Right? Just like that. If you can locate God's word for every situation of your life, you have established yourself. Those four scriptures that I gave you, these are my own combo. God said, I'm going to do something for you, wrote to me. He said, if they told you, you would not believe it. And I'm not doing it for you, I'm doing it for myself. Why? Every word of God is pure and it's true. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Let me give you two examples of the word of God I'm talking about. Nahum chapter 1, verse 9. He said, what did he imagine against the Lord? What is it that you think that will never happen? What do you imagine against the Lord? He continued. He said, he will make an utter end of it, for affliction will not rise to me. So, no matter where you find yourself, if you carry that word in your spirit, the Bible says, affliction will not rise to me again. It's a long time. Number, Nahum chapter 1, verse 9. Isaiah 34, verse 16. He said, look. Search from the book of the law and read. I remember when I said, I think TPT. He said, look, look, look in the scroll of the law and read. There are things to receive prayer about. There are things to fast about, but there are things to read about. You hear what I say? There are things to what? To fast about, to pray about, but there are some things to what? To read about. And guess what? God will never enforce anything on you, but life will place demand on you. He said, listen, seek ye from the book of the law and read. Read. He said, read them. Read them. Read them. Isaiah 40, 34, verse 16. I think that's a scripture for somebody. Because no matter how you cry, are we on Instagram? No matter how you cry, this is the word of God that the devil fears. Jeremiah 23, verse 29. Amen.
Amen.
What then is in the word of God? Three things. We've shared it before. We're going to share it again tonight. Whatever that is written is what? It is written. It can never be uttered. If it is written, it is written. The put is sitting now upon Jesus Christ's cross and is written there, the King of Jews. And all the people who plotted against him said, listen, sir, can you take that thing off? No, the man said, no, listen to this. I'm not going to do this. Because my wife has suffered so many things. He said, what happened? What I've written? I've written. Can I pray for you? Wherever you have been struggling about life, by the reason of tonight's prayer, it is written.
Amen.
It is written concerning you.
Amen.
That greatness is knocking your door.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
That's John chapter 19, verse 22. But if I said, listen to him, you know, this, it is written. You guys are not, can't take it away. Amen. Number one, that I want you to know. Number two, whatever is written, it is settled. Whatever that is written, it is written. But whatever that is written is what? Is settled. And the third one, whatever that is written, it is finished. John chapter 19, verse 30. So if you are not an adventure to go and get the word, life will face you. If you are not an agenda to be able to get the best of what God has given to you, you are treading a path that is not good. few things I want you to know about the Word of God as we round up tonight. Number one, the Word of God is not your mate. It is yes, what, and amen. That's why we call it trusting in God alone. Trusting in God alone. And lean not on your own understanding in all your way. Acknowledge Him. In God's word is yes and amen. It's not no or maybe. God's word does not rotate. It's abide forever. Number two. God cannot lie. You know, I spoke to one of the top pastors today, Kenaland, and he said, man of God, he said, I don't even understand myself. I said, understand what? I know. He said, I don't understand. He said, we now, by next week Sunday, we're going to have 8,000 churches planted already with two pastors. One will be leading and that one will be learning. When God says something, that is it. No matter the level of what is going on around you, when God says it is time for the children of Israel to come out of Egypt, that is it. And I decree, everything holding back, that is holding greatness back from you, may the Lord remove them in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
He said, God's word, 2 Corinthians 1:18-20, help me. 2 Corinthians 1:18-20. He said, but as the Lord God is true, our word towards you are not yes and say. In 19, he continued, he said, For the Son of God, Jesus Christ, who was preached among you by me, even by me and Silvanus and Timothy, was not yes and nay, but unto him it is yea. God's word is not no or maybe. God's word is not, let me double check. God's word is the power. Is the power. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's a verse 20. First, 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 20. It says, for all the promises of God in him are yea and amen. Yea and amen. Yea and amen. Somebody shout hallelujah. So God's word is what? Why must you trust God? God's word. Number one, it is what? Yes and amen. It does not change like human being. Number two, why must you trust in God's word? Because God cannot lie. Because God cannot lie, His word cannot fail. Because God's word cannot lie, then what? His word will not fail. The only thing that will make God to die is when his word fails, and his word cannot fail. It says Isaiah chapter 55, verse 9. It says, as the earth is far from there, it says, so my thoughts from your thoughts and my wisdom. It says, I have my word will not come back void to me. It says, the do that you were sent. So everything in life has a purpose, including you, and you will fulfill purpose.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So remember, God's word is not no or maybe. It is what? Somebody shout
hallelujah.
Number two. God cannot lie. No matter the situation you are going through right now, God cannot lie. Titus chapter 1 verse 2. Titus chapter 1 verse 2. It said, in hope of eternal life, which God that cannot lie promised the world before the world began. God cannot lie. God cannot lie. His word cannot fail. Titus 1:2. God cannot lie. His word cannot fail. Numbers 23, verse 19. Number 23, verse 19. He said, God is not a man that he should lie, nor son of a man that he should repent. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What about faithfulness? What about faithfulness? Number one, the faithfulness of God established everything. Because God will never take a break. So his word will always be working. God will never, Psalm 121, please. Psalm 121 from verse 1. He said, he that keepeth you neither sleep nor slumber. God said, no, I will not go on break because I don't know when it's going, what's going to happen next. Thank you, Jesus. Number one, God's word is yes. Number two, God cannot lie. Number three, God is faithful. God is a faithful father. Second Timothy chapter 2 verse 13. Say, if you faint not, God abide faithful, he cannot deny himself. Cannot deny himself. Did anybody find Timothy? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Say, if you believe, not yet, but you abide faithful. I'm reading a TPT version. Help me to read, please.
If you are faithful.
If you are faithful.
Remain faithful.
He remain faithful.
He cannot deny himself.
He cannot deny himself. Ah, I will lift up your hand, everybody, tonight. He said, Lord, empower me to play my part. Stand up on your feet and pray that prayer in 1 minute. Ramba shatala katala satode balaya katana bala. Ramba shakatala. Rambo sotonde beria baya katana bale katode shadabala. Ra katala shatana bale. Thank you, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. The word I've been talking about that we should trust in is the word of God. And the word of God, the Bible said, the word became flesh and dwelt among us. The word became what? It became flesh. Verse 14 of John 1. The word became flesh. So if you want the word to function for you, you want to trust in God's word to be able to guarantee you total success, you must what? You must know the word. Who is the word? Jesus. It's simple. What do you need to do then is surrender plus connection equals what? Submission. Let's take our seat. And for as many people who are saying this prayer today, wherever you are around the world, I want you to know that you don't need to get to hell. I want you to know that you don't need to go to hell. All you need to do is to go to God. You can choose to end up in hell. That's up to you. But no matter where you find yourself, fall forward. Fall into the hand of God, and God will take care of you. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Amen.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Amen.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Amen.
So all you need to do tonight is for you to give your life, to accept the life of Jesus, and return your own life to him, and then we'll make good case. Amen.
Amen.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Amen.
So lift up your left hand up and put your right hand in your chest and say this after me. Lord Jesus, I'm on yours. I know that you died for me on the third day. You rose up again. That I might be justified right now. My sins are forgiven. I'm a new creature in Christ Jesus. All things have passed away. All things have become new. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Be blessed in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
For as when I pray that prayer, you will never go back to the world.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name,
amen.
Amen. Someone shout hallelujah.
Amen.
It's offering time. It's offering time. Lift up your offering. And say your own prayer to it. Say whatever you want from God to be. And say, God, the purpose of this offering, the purpose of this tithe is towards this. It's towards your work, towards the work in the house of God. By this offering, tithe, or any kind of giving that you are giving today, God will strengthen you. You will never go down in the mighty name of Jesus. The hundredfold return seed will come upon it. In Jesus' mighty name, amen, 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 in Jesus' name. Let's cast off. Amen. Bless this communion. Is communion time? So, we bless this communion right now as the flesh and blood of Jesus. Let it secure us from any kind of attack. Let it protect us from any kind of backbiting. In the mighty name of Jesus. As we take this, we have eternal life. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. 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 In Jesus' name. Let's begin to appreciate the name of the Lord. Father, we thank you. Father, we give you all the glory. Father, we give you all the honor. Father, we give you all the adoration. Thank you for your love. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. As you have prayed tonight, so shall it be. I decree upon you the Spirit to connect to heaven in the mighty name of Jesus. God will open your ear to hear. You will hear God in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. The hand of God will never depart from you. Amen. I curse every tiredness in your life. Amen. Receive the energy to run your vision. Amen. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. I will say, surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives. And we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. Amen. It's my time to shine. It's my yellow light. By the empowerment of the Holy Spirit, we will rise and shine. Give somebody an life as we trust in God's word.